Hello and welcome back to Module 2. This is the second part of Module 2 and we're at the last part of the second part now. And we're going to be having a quick look at searching the future internet. Now this is a really, really quite tricky concept to explain. But basically all of the internet search engines we've looked at so far search the internet for things that have already been put on the web. We're always looking backwards with them. The problem with it is that if you're interested in a particular topic or whether you want to set up an early warning system either for yourself or for your school, you need to have the mechanisms in place so that if somebody publishes something about you or a thing online, you'll send an alert. And that's what we mean by searching the future internet. Now the best service that is available to help us do this is Google Alerts. And with Google Alerts, you can set up certain search terms so that every so often, Google will either instantly update you if something's written about your search term, or it will update you daily, or it will update you weekly. It's a really, really quite an easy thing to do. Let me just talk you through it now. Okay, so here I am in Google Alerts. These are all the alerts that I've already got set up. I've got 10 alerts at the moment. For example, I like to see when people write stuff about me, positive or negative. And I've also got in here some keywords about the schools that I work in and also Scottish education. Now, one of the things that I always recommend that head teachers do is they set up an alert with their school name in it. So I'm going to enter their Musselburgh Grammar School, which is a school that I used to be vice principal of a number of years ago. And in a minute, I'm going to create the alert. The reason that I would do this, of course, is because it would be a good example of an early warning system. You can see here the sorts of links that might come up. Google's just trawling the web for this at the moment. And I can now pick different options. So, for example, I want, as soon as somebody publishes to the web something about Musselburgh Grammar School, I'm going to get an email sent to me at ollybray@gmail.com. Create my alert, and that's it. I'll show you an example in a second about how it helped me when I was at Musselburgh Grammar School. Well, that was Google Alerts. Hopefully you can see the value of it. I searched there for Musselburgh Grammar School, which is my old school. I've been using Google Alerts now since 2008, and I went back in my email archive and actually pulled out one of the Google Alerts from October the 29th, and I remember it well as a school leader. It flashed up in my inbox that one of our pupils from Musselburgh Grammar School had been involved in a football match. I was able to click on the link. It had been published in the local paper. I was able to go and get the boy out of class to praise him on his success. And if I hadn't had the Google Alerts in place, I would never have known that had happened in the first place. So it's a great early warning system, but it's also a great way to hoover up different pupil achievements that are published on the internet that they might not be telling you about in school. Well, I hope that you've enjoyed the second part of Module 2. Remember, the first part was just the introduction. We've finished looking at all of the different search tools now. There's still an opportunity for you guys to discuss and to think about how we can make better use of search. As we move on to the third section of Module 2, we're going to be having a little bit of a look at copyright. So I'll see you in that set of videos. Thanks very much. Thank you.